I said good day, sir!
Welcome back, everybody, here to your coverage of the Defense Season 4, where we are doing our final tiebreaker matchup. That's right, we want to know who will face up against Dignitas in the lower bracket of the, well, let's say lower bracket, round one of the playoffs of the defense. Will it be EG or will it be Quantic? It's kind of crazy to think we got these two teams of such high caliber going up against each other. But EG and Quantic, they are the two guys that found themselves drawn for the third position in the group, and that is Group C. It was a pretty rough group as it was. The Alliance playing really strong. They went 6-2 out of their group. 4FC managing to claim second position in that group, 5-3. And then we had our draw, 4-4 for Quantic as well as EG. Z-Rage, they're the ones who actually get the Wooden Spoon Award for the entire group stage, in fact, having the lowest result at 1-4-7. And, well, now let's see how it all unfolds. Of course, we have EG led by their captain, Fear. Their full roster, J.O., Demon, Bamboo, and Beaters. And then through the lineup of Quantic, we've got 3-3-3. It's an older tag of Goldblack. Actually had a bit of a chat to him before we started up. They said, well, they need a little bit of a luck. It's a best of one game. So he's going to use his lucky tag, and that is the 3-3-3 tag. Funzi, Soshka, 7. Of course, a lot of people know him as Bucking Mad, but he's going to, like, impersonate his captain and go with the 777, and then Silent, who is always in love with Mila, will be taking up the last role as the Quantic 5th. So let's see how our drop's unfolding. It looks like, guys, we're in for a bit of a surprise here. Fear has got to decide right now if it's worthwhile letting the Wisp through. Goldblack bans out the Broodmother, a hero which has been played a little bit more and more. Bamboo loves playing the Broodmother. In this scenario, though, as we're talking to the Demon before we start this off, he is going to go into that support role as OD is banned out. We got ourselves a Wisp game, peoples. We got ourselves a Wisp game, and it's going the way of Quantic. What a way. Like, you start talking about the fact, like, a best of one is so unstable. Anything could happen in a best of one matchup. And then you say, okay, we're going to bait and we're going to push the Wisp through. And Fear is happy to let it happen. Wisp now in the mix. So Quantic, they've got so many options for what they want to combine up with this one. We get the Batrider up for EG. So it gives them their options for that. But the question is, do they just want to block it out? Right now, we've seen team, like, IC Cup is the ones that have been doing this the most. You see a Wisp being picked up, and they just block pick the CK. So you don't get the Wisp-CK combination. That would still, no matter how you look at it, be a brutal combination, no matter where you go. But Tiny works, Weaver works, all these different combinations, which, because everyone's like, oh, you know, we're never going to get CK Wisp anyway, so let's find different ways of making him work. And those last two, which I mentioned, they're the ways to go, and EG just goes with a Coddle. So they say, okay, you want to take Wisp, not a problem. We're going to go for stronger laning, and Quantic are like, well, we're happy with our strength of our lanes. CK comes out, as well as the Wisp. So the combination is there for Goldblack, and EG, with a Coddle as well as a Batrider. Well, these lanes could really become very, very messy. EG, the possibilities of running an aggressive tri-lane, but their Keeper of the Light is a support behind two more on that bottom lane. But they don't know who they're going to be up against in that bottom lane. Chaos Knight as well as the Wisp, they could be going middle lane for all they know. Looking to use the tether to clear off the tree line, get a little bit easier pull, hope to get the Gnolls up and running so you get the pull into the middle lane, work properly. And now EG, they're going to work it out too. Like, they can't ban against the supports. They don't know if they can ban against the middle lane. The only thing they could really take out is the long laners, or if they are going to run an aggressive tri-lane, then they've got to get rid of what's going to control that. And they take out a Prophet, so technically they are banning out a long laner. Then they just Prophet to be removed. Means too, you can't have this full-on global. It's not going to be everywhere all at once. I'm wondering, too, if they're last ban out. And I'm interested to see if this combo is going to happen or not. But Lifestealer could just abandon the top lane. They feel it's not worthwhile going up there. Just put Lifestealer inside the jungle in the early set. Put CK Wisp in that middle lane. And then use the Lifestealer to infest into CK. And then you've got three heroes that can go anywhere across the map. Just start, like, tag-teaming them all up. Naga Siren will be the ban out by Goldblack. And this does start to... I'm throwing out there the Lifestealer is a possibility right now for Goldblack. If he wants to do it, if he wants to give her a shot, they can even run Lifestealer on that bottom lane. You're going up against Dakota down there. Need an extra kind of support, which can be nice. Some level of control. SD would be the best one if you're looking to stop people who are going to be like disrupting people, like with Batrider's Lasso. Put that disruption off. You have a whole Batrider there, or make sure the hero doesn't suffer any more damage by disrupting them out. Darkseer is going to be the Fear of Fear, so you're going to remove it out. And Goldblack, the last one. What's he want? SD may also be something he has to ban out himself. And the only reason I'm saying that is because right now I'm looking at the lineup and CK Wiz jumping in. It's good, but any kind of disruption, anything which slows them down from achieving their kill straight away, is something they just can't afford to have. And that's exactly what he would do. But they actually ban out dying. And they must really be thinking this can be an aggressive trial in on bottom lane. But they got the hero, which they fear the most. Goldblack, he's got a lot of experience with the Undying. But doesn't want to be facing it in this game. And there's that SD for EG. So as expected. But then Puck for Quantic. Still very open for their lanes. But more than likely, well, we kind of know it's going to be Funzie's Puck. The question will be, which lane is it on? It could be top lane, it could be safe lane, it could be any of these options. They can still run a jungler. Goblack still got his chin inside the pool. Fear, well, he's got both of his supports. If he's going to really run this aggressive trial lane on bottom lane, they might have to look down the lines of an Alchemist. That way, he's got the AoE stun, but then you also saw the problem with that in our last game, which we cast today, where the Puck just phase shifts and evades. So you can't always use it to lock down the Puck, you need somebody else. But they're going to give it a shot. They're going to give it a shot. They are going to... they're going to attempt an aggressive trial lane here. And that means that Goblack realizes what's coming his way. He needs some saving. Some hold on the Alchemist. I was thinking Rubick very early on. But I'm not quite sure if that's really going to be enough for them. Now we go with Goblack's Chen instead. The other thing sitting in the back of my mind. Coddle, SD, and Alchemist, they take a while before they'll have enough power that they can really contest a lane. And if they want to, they'll just throw Puck on bot. As I said, Puck, he's great at evading off what Alchemist, Coddle, or SD's going to throw at him. Get those early levels up in phase shift, get that cooldown time a little bit lower. 5 seconds. And you have a lot more to evade, so you wouldn't worry about just evading an Illuminate when it comes in. And that means then CK and Wisp can go in the middle lane. The problem if they do that then is that Chen won't have access to his jungle. He'll have to run to the Dire side jungle, but that wouldn't be a bad option either. Farm up inside the Dire side jungle, then come up to gank in the middle lane with the CK Wisping combination. That can still work, but it just means thinking a little bit more, well, I'd say outside the box, but this is Quantic we're talking about. Quantic don't even have a box. It's an open field. Bouncing into the last man out by Fear and Warlock. Very little to no hesitation banning that one out. With the bounty under ban out, they are still thinking about that top lane. I'm still thinking about the Lifestealer. Batrider, he'll have some fun with the Lifestealer. But bounty, he could have actually caused some issues for the Batrider. Not going to happen. Puck could also still go up against the Batrider. There's no problem with that one either. And throw a different hero onto that bottom lane. But if you really want one person to go solo up against Nasty, Cuddle, and Alchemist, Jugger will be the last pickup from EG. So that gives us our mid solo. I say mid solo, could also be top lane solo. And this is also still assuming that EG is going to be running in across the tri lane. We've seen long lane juggernauts in the past from EG. Batrider also capable of doing the same thing, but I'll actually be surprised. Oh, they could leave Alchemist on the top now. With the Juggernaut selection, that gives him a lot more health and mana to run around with on the bottom. An SD Disruption, while it's not the great combo that works with the Alchemist stun to hold him there and then do the extra damage, the Juggernaut spin after SD does the Disruption allows Juggernaut to get into position, and then the Illuminate too can look for the body block. And things like that really start to screw around with the Wisp and the CK, because he'll just spin himself up the second Wisp and CK want to initiate on him. And they don't have that lockdown, the Juggernaut. But Quantic, they need to make sure they've got a secondary source of DPS. CK is good, but if he gets shut down the early stages, then you have something else. Puck won't be enough. While EG, like, they got Lasso, they got good napalm damage, Once obviously the levels come up on that one, you got Alchemist, who's always going to farm and have good damage, even though it may not be enough to carry up against a full team like Mouseports. And then you got Juggernaut, like Juggernaut's ulti, nice little jumps around, enough to kill off a Wisp if he's ever caught out of position. Chain creeps try and soak that one up, so try and carry the undead with you at all times. And Goldblank's last selection. 17 seconds of bonus time that's left. Let's see how these lanes are actually going to come to play. Because Quantic, they're still open for what they want to do, and Clockwork will be the last one. So they pick a long lane hero. And it will be Bucking Mad onto that. So let's see our lanes. J.O. as the Juggernaut. Of course, he is the new solo mid. Fear is the number one carry position. Demon on that Batrider. So that's a support Batrider. Demon's got more experience, though, on the Batrider. So that might be the reason. Like, you see Bamboo as well as Beaters. Yep, that's going to be... It could still be their aggressive tri-lane. Man, this EG have so many options about how they want to lane this. They could really just split it up however they want to. But either way we look at it, everyone kind of goes on the heroes, which would be predicted for them. It's just the lanes they go to. It's up to the teams. And that means early scouting. Look and see what's up, what's around. And J.O. already showing. Nice ability, already leveled up. Prepare for Tango, Salve, so bottle build for the middle, but expecting a lot of harassment to come his way. Bamboo will be the SDB Diz. Keeper of the Light. And everyone's moving towards the top lane to start with. Batrider. Demon's almost built to abandon the lane. In fact, I think this is it. EG is not running an aggressive tri lane on this. They're just holding back. Demon will farm up inside the jungle. Juggernaut. Showing some style in the middle lane. Beaters. He'll throw down some early wards, but he'll just be looking to stack. Be looking to stack and help up Demon, because Demon's built for bottle. Unless they're going to run bottle for both mid and bottom, it's not something most teams really want to keep doing these days. The main reason for that being, if you start running bottle for both mid and bottom, you got that slow on the courier. It's just so far to go. It's a very slow bottle transition time. Soshka and Silent are going to want to remain on the bottom lane, so it will be the CK Soshka. Silent as the Wisp, or Io. Goldblack into his role as Chen. And now they look over to Funzi, middle lane. Pulled more consumables, all from Goldblack too, with an old talisman. So expecting Funzi to be a little bit more aggressive there in the middle lane up against J.O. Just not too over-aggressive, because then you won't have even time to pop off yourself and you'll go down. While Goldblack, top lane. I mean Goldblack, up Bucking Mad. The long lane solo, Clockwork Goblin. Oh, what? Wait, what? Normally when you do that, you put the box down here and then you chop out the one at the back so they go whoop and then whoop. But in this scenario, I don't think Bucking Mad really intended that. I really don't think he intended that. He'll block a range creep out too now. Yeah, he really did not intend this at all. And Beaters as well as Bamboo already waiting for him to come up. They know a Clockwork Goblin's a hell of a lot easier to kill than any other hero. And they've already put down a nice, aggressive Observer Ward. That's mainly to watch for this camp here so it can't be pulled. So Goblack, Beaters. Happy to take some extra damage. Funzi taking a lot of damage there from J.O. As he said, he'll be over-aggressive trying to slow down J.O.'s bottle. You make sure these salves go to work. But Goldblack, how's he able to stay so close in here? Well, this is the reason why. Bamboo's stacking. There's also a stack up on the Trolls and the Wilkins. But in the meantime, CK free farming. Wisp getting some good levels too, already starting off in the port through. Trying to bring down these mud golems at the right time. All he's looking for is levels. Even if he misses out in CS, he might be a little bit sad. But first blood, top lane. Quick healing sound, not enough to save Bucking Mad. He really just doesn't have a hero to go up on this top lane. They can't as well. It's almost got to be an abandonment of that lane. But if Bucking Mad does that, then he knows it's just going to be futile. Because he can't find farm anywhere else. Like, we're going to have Chen give him a creep so they can tank up so he can find farm inside the jungle. That's the only other option he has. So he's got to tough it out. Find the levels. But with all these double stacks which have been set up by EG, he's not going to find anything. Funzi, though, he's finding some really good farm in the middle lane. 9-3. Now 10-3 up against the 4-0 of the Juggernaut. Juggernaut catches a small break with the invis room, but his smaller break is the fact he doesn't have a bottle yet. Where is his gold? It's just not there with four last hits. Funzie's bottle's on the way to him on the flying dodo. So he's already off to a great start. CK 14 for 4, obviously Alchemist, farming up a lot too. Fear, wanting to make sure he's able to fight. He's got 2 points up in that unstable concoction. But really right now, he's going to be focusing on money. He's going to need those items. Oh, then again, he's also going to need the acid spray and the concoction once Silent hits level 6. Which if he keeps doing these pull-throughs, he's going to hit pretty damn fast. Not to mention, he just keeps denying up the creep wave. Goblack's up to level 3.5. I'll be ready to push out this lane in a moment. Funzie copying a little bit of damage here from J.O. But J.O.'s going to be a little bit more cautious when he starts using this spin now. Funzie's getting closer to that level 6, and once Funzie is level 6, then J.O.'s in more trouble once the spin goes down. Funzie is going to let the other thing for him. When his phase shift goes down, then he's in a little bit more trouble. Because with the phase shift, J.O. then will have an option to throw out his ulti. And you already see his build. Double stats, 2 spin. That's his build right now. Racking up those stat points makes it a lot harder for Funzie to kill him off, but also means that J.O. doesn't have this option for a healing ward. He has the courier now up and running. That's the bottle back in the courier, and then goes for the spin. But Funzie just goes to the other side, up on the high ground. He can really play this one. J.O. with no spin, orb in 3 seconds time, and in from the side. Throws down the nuke. Goblack says hello. Bucky Mad died in the meantime, but I was going to stick with that middle lane. Shadow Demon kills off the clockwork. The middle lane's more important. Clockwork can just keep on dying. He's not getting any experience up here. His major issue is what's going to happen once... Ooh, concoction, fear, and he gets it off. It's some kind of damage. It's nothing much more than that. He's not missing much of the creep wave, even though it's now coming range of the tower. Is he building into... Okay, so he put the second point into Grievous Creep. He's realizing the Quantic aren't going to rotate just yet. And they don't need to. Wisp now level 4.75, so this is just a countdown timer. Both these teams, if they can find pickoffs, they'll go for it. But Batrider wants a lasso, a Blink Dagger lasso before he's going to initiate. He's got the lasso, but he needs the Blink Dagger as well. Funzie wants his own Blink Dagger, so he can move in and out nice and quickly. Or does he want to wait? I don't think he does. There's a smoke being purchased up. Goblin's trying to keep this creep wave back. Quite successful at doing so too. Cog's lasting a very, very long time. And that should be his level 2. And now he's going to have Rocket on this top lane. He'll at least have something to play around with for some last hits. And also do some extra damage to Fear and Bambo. And Soshka, Magic Wand, treads up and running. Armlet won't be up by the time that Silent's ready to fight with him. But that's okay. They'll only be looking to gank up middle lane more than likely. J.O.'s escape mechanism, once that spin goes down, they'll go there. Funzie, he's also walking around with the ulti and haste rune. He's staring down this Juggernaut. He's got one bottle charge up his sleeve, but Juggernaut wants to spin, so at least his bottle charge will regenerate his mana as opposed to just regenerating life points. But while he does this, he's forced to hold back. He's 13 for nil up against a 35 for 10 puck in the middle lane. Funzie is the man with the control here. Overall, you can also see Quantic. They have the better control. You'd expect this too, considering you're running a Chen, who now has level 6, so just under 6 minutes in, we got ourselves a Hand of God on the field. No surprise that Goblack has a successful Chen. Funzie, gotta be careful. Demon's coming in, it's nighttime now. And Funzie, good silence time. Very, very good silence time. He even jumps up for B-Diz. Funzie, he's gonna get this kill. He got it on B-Diz. The orb flew straight through him. That warning rift, it stunned, it actually silenced up Demon, so we couldn't lasso. And Beatiz was basically in the direct line for the orb after stealing the illusion rune. And now Funzie wants the top lane. He throws down the dream call. Bamboo goes inside. He's just hiding here inside the ST disruption. But then Clockwork pushes him back, gets a kill. There's that face shift we're talking about. Evades the stun of fear, which we also didn't hit there on freaking fucking Mad. And Beaters, man. You can count himself unlucky. He didn't have vision of what was going down just then. And at the same time, he does... It doesn't change the fact he got caught out. And now on bottom lane. The undead army, plus the health regeneration of the Satyr. They still don't want to push out this bottom tier 1 tower. Whiffs does have level 6. So now we've got the global option here for Silent. Anywhere they want to go, they can go. Oh, Funzie in the middle lane, back to his farming. Soshka. Getting close to Renner finishing up those drums. Can at least now buy up. 450 intel. Back to that top lane. Just Rocket saying a load of bamboo. Clockwork up to level 4.5 now off those ganks on top lane. He's going to come in. And it's some cocky play coming out here from Bucking Mad. Lamuncha to Tango. At the same time, in through the rear, there's that Wisp ultimate. Hand of God keeps Silent alive. 3 seconds, needs to live a little bit longer. Fear with that tether stun, Reality Rift, and Sosh can be left behind. Goldback's already picked up a double kill. Picking up the SD at the back. Now a 4 second stun. Couldn't have asked for something better. The concoction's gonna go. It's gonna be an ice AoE stun, but Reality Rift, oh, he already used it. And Fear managed to escape himself out. Wisp Boldy goes to work for the first time. Is able to secure them kills up on the top lane. Who's that Rocket scouting for? Just kind of thought it might be scouting out for Demon at some point. I don't think he realizes, but if a Rocket flies... it's only level 1 Rocket, wouldn't be enough. Sasha gonna get sent back to base. That's his drums. He'll pick it up when he gets back. Well, should be able to. He's gonna be a little bit short, isn't he? Picks up an Ogre Club instead. So BKB will be his... will be his path. Kind of ignore the drums. And go straight into that immunity. Because what does EG have that goes through BKB? Lasso and Purge. The two things that will go through it. Funzie. He kind of wants a kill here in the middle lane. Jero also wants to farm here in the middle lane. But he's not getting the opportunity. Still 25 for nil up against a 52 for 16 Puck. He is getting nothing. The upside is the fact that Demon's managed to pick 64 CS out of the jungle. But that 64 CS only equates to being the fourth highest net worth. CK is still leading the way, just over 4k, but he's right behind that of the Alchemist. But that's an Alchemist also with Grievous Greed, but also an Alchemist that's died. Well, actually, sorry, hasn't died. Has been there to watch two of his teammates die. The fact that Clockwork is leading the kill count. Funzie throws the puck ulti. And there goes your Wisp Baldi in through the rear. Who are they going to go on? Start on Bamboo. Nice disruption. That's the problem with the SD. Funds is already dead. They will pick off the support here, but they need more help. Fear, 4 seconds stun. Keep that tether. The spin from Jo doing a hell of a lot of damage, but it's not enough to get the kill. Wisp pulls him back out again. Bamboo. Boy, what demon. Lasso's up on the Phantasm of CK. Fucking mad. Got to throw down these cogs right now. The only way to live. But then again, there isn't a way to live. The cogs, in fact, are going to trap in Soshka, who just came in on the back of a smoke. TP'd in, and that ward saw the TP come. And now they'll see him revealed. Oh, poor demon. I don't mean to laugh at him. I don't mean to laugh at him. He'll be laughing at himself at the conclusion of this game. And then he gets something lucky. Invis rune for him, but no lasso to use it. Also, not really enough mana to really capitalize on it, so he's having to use all the bottle charges. While Silent getting free experience on this bottom lane. He's level 9 on that Wisp. Leveled up with both Puck and CK is the highest levels on the map. Level 8 is as close as Fear is getting, but he's almost hit that level 9. And Silent will still stay in front of all of them. Free farm on bottom lane, so we assume the arcane boost to be coming up from him. That will be the bottom. Range creep to go down, and then what's he going to do? Bring down the bottom tower. He needs Chen for that. And Goldblack already up to level 8. Building into the mech, but not actually there. That's the reason why. But I'll say he's missing a lot of money for a Chen. Goes back at base. The form of the recipe on the courier. We're going again. Ulti is up. And looking to the bottom lane. Leave one observer ward behind. And Silent. Well, they realize they get spotted. They get rid of the observer ward, leaving a sentry ward behind, that was. But Silent can still ulti anywhere. And Jo, with the easiest target, Funzie. Well, the Illuminate's going to keep him out for just a little bit longer. What level is that? Only looking at... Oh, it's actually level 3 from Beat is. Mesh hit level 6. And BD's going for a very unconventional build on the Keeper of the Light. Most Coddles, you always want to have your level 6. Oh, the Trotto! So the mech recipe. Demon wants it. Blinks down. Park Coldy gonna fly, but he got the courier. And will now TP out. Realize the Fonz is already thrown out the stun. That was not the full mech, but it was the majority of it. Chan can still buy up the Buckler, but he won't be able to finish that thing up now for 2 minutes 50. And that's a long time not to be able to just instantly force down that bottom tower because he had mech. But Quantic will force something else instead. They want the tier 1 tower remit. But the Illuminate's going to work. And Funzi, too close. Got a phase shift. Didn't phase shift to Juggernaut! Clockwork's gonna come in. He won't bait it off. The Cog's gonna push Fear back. He's got no extra mana on him. And they're killing off Bamboo as fast as possible. But the Wisp's already gone down. And now Demon, he lands Uza, real Soshka. And then Reality Rift, trying to pull himself away, goes onto Fear on that one. And Chem, he is sending him back. But the damage is gonna be enough from Alchemist Concoction. And flies out, gets the kill. Blink out from Demon, flame breaking them around. He was looking for Bucking Mad, but he's very low on mana. Needed to get back to where she bottle charge up properly, and the healing ward that went down the middle lane. Level 3, giving EG a lot of life points to fight, not only underneath their tower, but also with the number advantage going that way. And that was just a misplay coming out by Funzi. Didn't tap that phase shift fast enough. Needed to evade that concoction. The fact he went down instantly meant he also had to buy back to be part of that engagement. But once he came back, it was already too late. There was no point for a dream call, there was no point for rift orbs, all those kind of jazz. It was just damage control. And J.O. knows it. He's now trying to take this bull by the horns. TP's himself back to the bottom lane, actually. More fun to be had down here. Mid tier 1 will be held out by beaters. The pings are coming out saying, can we take this one down? But up against the Keeper of the Light, this is actually when the 3 Chakra and the 3 Illuminate do come in handy. It means the BDs can just keep spamming his abilities non-stop, as opposed to just having a little bit more throttled with them. But he doesn't have an ultimate, which means he can't just instantly drag people into that middle lane. Or have the Blinding Light available. Blink away. Demon popping off the Invis Rune. That wasn't a Wisp ulti, that's just Silent as well as Soshka having a look around. And Silent should be tethering himself down to Soshka like right now. So then they can go. Geo, that's the reason why he's up. Magic Community Spin. Reality Rift will not work on that. Go back to his farming. He's looking for he's looking for his mech, is what he's looking for. Once the courier is up in 20 seconds time, he'll have it. He may even send it to pick up one of the point boosters. Build into his Aghanim Scepter. If he feels that's what's really required, might even look towards a 4 staff. So very dependent. Blink dagger for Puck, so now Funzi gets his maneuverability. But 1 second on that courier. That courier is going to be very, very latent. Yeah, so there's the mech, chainmail, wards, ogre club. That's actually... Goldblack's picking up an ogre club. So, okay, he wants live points for these fights. But there's still going to be him looking to go into the ultimate. Ultimate buff up for the Aghanim Scepter. I doubt we're seeing a Chen BKB. But he does have a lot of life points, 1100 to boot. And good armor too, 9 of them. Concoction, coming top lane. It's gonna go there on the clockwork. Blink Lasso. EG, they're getting greedy, but they're gonna get it. Juggernaut, just spinning in damage. And CK, whoa! What are we doing in here? Demon's gonna go down, Soshka gets the kill on that one, Silent gonna get stunned up and he'll go down. Fear and J.O. diving on that T1 tower, but hey, why not? It ended up being a 4v2 and then another 4v2. That made no sense whatsoever from Quantic to jump in like that. And EG, they got the silver platter. Quantic, they still hold the advantage, but not for much longer. And they're bringing everybody back to that top lane. Soshka, Silent, they're up here. And you look for Bucking Man to get that latch in with a clockwork hook. Puck, the only one not available. But he can TP, but he's making the decision if he wants to come. Okay, decision made. All 5 together, Soshka sent back so he can heal up. But he'll TP back in a moment. While the rest of EG prepare for a fight, beaters. I think it'll start spamming off this Illuminate. Also, considering that one was way too short, he needs to use his Chakra. He's too low on mana, and he gives it to Fear instead. Fear also needs his mana. But at the expense of having beaters, who right now can't cast an Illuminant. He needs to wait at least 5 more seconds. Troll Trap keeping J.O. out. Demon giving him the Flying Vision. Into his Firefly. Tether still up and running. Focus on the tower, and now beaters. Pops the ultimate. And the Illuminant's already flowing off. Nice stun, AoE, and there's your spin. Geo is going to be a lot of damage there to Sun. He's going to move himself further away, and Geo, he will pick off Sun. No, he won't. The tether back in again. Alchemist's chemical acid spray is going to kill him off, but not before Soshka picked up a double kill for this. EG lost 3, and Fear trying to fight, but 4 seconds on the stun. They've got to get some space. Now the send back will come. Puck not going to jaunt into that one. Geo out a little bit too far. Concoction coming off. They're too close. They're too close. Puck thought it might have been him. The Centaur with a stump. It holds Fear in position. J.O. just threw out the ult. He able to kill up the clockwork. And now he wants Goldblack. One slice and he gets him. Funzy. He can't get a revenge kill. Even with the Urs to help him, maybe he can. Bottling up. Jumps in. CK back in the mix. The attack doesn't hit on J.O. Soshka looks for more. He sees beaters TPing himself in. Same with Bamboo. The poison able to get that kill. Where's Wisp going? He's in behind. Tethers down. He might just cancel off the tether and take Funzy back to base. Do it with the orb. Maybe they need to keep him there. Spirit damage. Does he break the tether? Yeah, he does. So Soshka can remain. Fear. Maybe Soshka whizzes right now. We're going to take him back by the whiz. Fear. Looking for the concoction. He's going to throw it. Rocker's going to fly. BKB from Soshka. 3 seconds on the stun. Bamboo. Clockwork. Latches through them. And the cogs pushing Fear away. But he got the lasso up on Soshka. He'll reality rip himself. Fear onto the high ground. The urn charge is killing him off. He can't live through it. The healing ward from J.O. tries to help me. He'll pop off the TP. 135 gold goes to waste, but he could have tried. He had to try something. And now Silent as well as Soshka-san. He's not keeping up, though. He's got to stay with him for this reality rift to work. And there's the rift. Tether stun. Chaos Bolt. There's your mana. 4 seconds on it. More than enough time to kill off J.O. As in fact, Bucking Mad that picks up the double kill. Beat is a long way from home. Running up to the tier 2 tower. 16 to 13 now on the board. Tier 2 tower fortified up by EG, only way to hold on to it. Well, now that everything has started to settle itself down, now we're looking as far as items. Radiant's top tower is under attack. Maybe a little bit of miscommunication here. All we need right now is a double mech, and we basically have the combo. The two urns, one up on Bucking Mad, one over Radiant's on Silent. Considering how split up these fights keep getting, I suppose either way, you will get the urn charges. But then you look through the EG lineup. You got Fear with his Shadow Blade, almost finished off the BKB. And then Quantic. They've only got one thing that will go through that as far as a lockdown, and that's the Clockwork. Clockwork can hold him in with his ultimate. That will do the stun and then put the cogs up. Well, it won't burn. Because it's magic community. It can still hold Fear in position. Doesn't really help our Soshka though, because Soshka will be wanting to get in nice and close to also bring him down. But now that he's got that BKB up and running, which we already saw being used to evade that concoction and turn to fight again, he's going to feel a lot more confident about being inside those cogs if he can get in. Just means he can't reality rift himself in. Could find himself just swapping out the Alchemist into a safer land. Quantic again, 5-man Dota wants to happen. Fear, all he wants to do is farm up this damn BKB. But there's no time. Demon's already fireflied up. He wants to fight this. A blink, lasso, 4-star, dragging him back down to the Ancients would get themselves an instant kill. Especially with J.O. walking around with those 2 points and up in ultimate. Get one person out by themselves and you got yourself a kill. Goldblight goes back to his farming. Well, something else came out in the courier. 1600 up on that CK. It's got buyback available, point booster for the clockwork, so he's building into the Aghanims. Funzi's still walking around with his 1500. Having buyback is almost more important right now, but he knows he wants to build into that Scythe of Ice. If not the Scythe of Ice, he needs a Scythe of Ice. I was thinking Yule Scepter may be an option if he just wants to take somebody out of the engagement. Jumping in directly and taking out that SD will be a good thing. We already saw it tonight from Faded, both times he played that puck. He decided to go in with a Dagon build, and you get horrible support heroes like SD that has caused you so many issues. Silence, Dagon, or bump, done. Dead. Instantly. that requires them to get the straight initiation in. And to do that without having all the other interference that comes from the rest of EG. Bottom lane push, Godblack just keeping himself a little bit more secret here. That rocket. Let's point out the fact that no one's here for EG. So they moved the double hell bears to the front lines. And that means EG's got to bring themselves down here. Beat is, yep, 4 points. 4 points. Pops the ulti. And starts the recall. Radiant's middle tower is under attack. Actually, just use blinding light. No recall being used. Just orb and go. And now it's fucking mad too close. Those Illuminous just keeping them out too far. Takes care of the creep wave. Blink lasso, and he got one. Juggernaut ultis him as quickly as possible. Cogs to go down. Hand of God will not keep fucking man alive long enough. Tries to ulti him, buying some time because Silent came in. I don't know if he was trying to pull out his teammate. Either way you look at it, he brought in Soshka, and Soshka's now going to go down. They weren't expecting all of EG to be here, but when you got a keeper of the line, of course, it's going to bring everybody else in, and Goldblack bounced back now, and he will go down. There is no answer to that. Maybe a push in the middle lane from Funzie would be the only other answer. But they just lost CK, Wisp, and Chen, and they will lose a tier 1 tower on bottom lane. That's a guarantee. Funzie will just do as much damage to this tier 2 tower as possible. Orb, Rift, take the creep wave out, and then look to the tier 2 tower. Structures are fortified. And that will be the tier 1 tower gone. Funzie just escapes out. Fear already came back to defend that tier 2 tower in the mid. And Godblack. I mean, fucking mad. I gotta stop seeing numbers and thinking Godblack. Fucking mad, back to the top lane. Needs more time, needs more space. EG, they don't need time, they don't need space, they need kills, and they're gonna find one. Soshka, two out. Too far out. Way too far out here on the bottom lane. This is the easiest kill of Demon's life. You just gotta get it right. They're bringing in more help. They are definitely securing this kill. Drag him up, pull him in, damage him down. BKB won't matter. He didn't pop it anyway. And now five heroes in the bottom lane. It's now the tier 2 tower in the bottom lane for EG to take. They're grabbing this advantage back. And JO. Gotta go for a build, which we're not seeing from every Juggernaut these days. A lot of Juggernauts preferred having that Aghanim Scepter, having all the bounces on the ultimate instead. Orb to fly, but the healing ward is still down there. Spirit's not doing enough, and Fear puts the Toxic Spray. It's holding Quantic really back past this line. If they want to go over that line, it means they must commit to defend that tower. And Demon wants to make sure they don't. Tier 1 and Tier 2 town, plus the death of Soshka on the bottom lane. And EG looking very good now. They're getting kills, they're getting items. They're getting momentum, more importantly. And Soshka, he's not getting anything. Seen spend a lot of his money. Gonna build that armlet. Needs the recipe for it now, and he's good to go. Meanwhile, Alchemist back to the farming. 4 points up in that Grievel's Greed. He's up to level 16, so maxed up on the ulti. And it's Assault Cuirass time. Did he just point up the Hyperstone? Yep. Hyperstone purchase, but he's keeping the AC a little bit more secret for now. I'm having the Shadowblade BKB. There's no reason just to show his plans to the world. Oh, nice camp over on the side. Geo, just be stacking that one for Fear. In fact, they're going to stack both the camps now. Fear remaining just a little bit too close there. Throws the Acid Spray. At least get himself a double stack down here. And the Acid Spray will kill off the rest of these Kobolds. And remember, that's all going to work out with the Grievel's Greed. Silent, using that Wisp Ulti just to snipe out the tier 1 tower on the top. Meanwhile, on bottom lane, Demon is the easiest killer Quantic's life before, and now he's going to realize just how many people are there. Blinks himself east, orb flying too. Four star, he's riding the rim and will TP out on it too. They can't catch him there. Fonzie tried to throw the ulti out to catch him, but it's basically on the top part of the map where no one can go. Unless you're a Batrider. Smoke time by Quantic. Must be thinking Roshan, EG doing exactly the same thing. In they go, 4 points healing ward. They're just using the smoke as cover fire. There's no observer wards looking for this one. Is there an orb? Is there something? They can't see it, even that acid spray. There's the rocket. Now they know what's going on. EG, they're gonna be fast. They're going to be very, very fast. This one, Clockwork, Bamboo used himself as a body block. He even gets himself forced off out of that area. Roshan killed by the Dire, and then Puck snatches the Aegis of the Immortal. He's got it in his hands. Quantic, they got the Aegis. Will it be enough, though? EG, only two heroes on the sidelines. Fear's on the run, but he's being dusted up, and he will go down. AC will not save him. Soshka picked up a double kill. Hand of God really going to hard work there. JO's on the run. The Aegis doesn't trigger. The no demons over in the corner with no Firefly. He's already used it, but Quantic don't care about that. They want the tier 2 tower on bottom lane. And EG's advantage. They tried for Roshan. They got the kill, but no one was able to pick it up. And jump in, Funzy. Searching for Demon. He sees him. Again, Demon right in the rim, skateboarder style. Four stomps away, so he's going to get stunned out there. And Soshka, they can't catch up to him in time. They've already taken the tier 2 tower. Clockwork. What did you just latch to? No one. Ulti on cooldown now for that. BT's up for the Batrider as well. I think Demon's realized maneuverability is going to be a big thing. A little bit of higher movement speed than a lot of the other treads. But the more important thing is they're able to BT everywhere across the map. Keep those pushes going. And also come back when the time is right. Jaya back to his farming, but Wiz coming in. Instantly has to spin. They got nothing to stop this. But double TPs from EG. There's no kill, and the Wiz Baldi was the only thing that was used up by Quantic. In fact, that's EG. Oh! Demon actually got really close just then. Good thing it was BTs. So EG, they only ended up using 270 gold for those TPs. One out, one in. Not to mention the 1 minute cooldown timer. But Quantic just need a moment. Or if not Quantic, just Funzy. Gotta rub the sleep out of his eyes. He only wakes up like 5 minutes before each game. So they're going to be good to go. Hopefully in a moment. Just a reminder for people who have just tuned in, we're doing the defense tiebreaker. Earlier today, we did have the matchup. Mousesports going up against Next.KZ. That was the first match of the playoffs for the defense in the lower bracket round. If you want to see the details for that one, you can head yourself over to the-defense.com. If you don't want to see the results for it and you just want to watch the VOD, you can stay tuned here on the live stream. The rebroadcast will come out at the conclusion of this game. There'll be more matches as well coming up. No matches tomorrow. The Sunday is a no-Dota day for the joinDOTA live stream. But we'll be back on Monday with VP versus Team Empire. That'll be coming up at 18 CEST. One of the other lower bracket matches. The winner of this game will play up against Team Dignitas and then 4FC versus Liquid. And that basically ramps up your lower bracket. Whilst an all Ukrainian winners bracket one semi-final. And that's going to be Na'Vi versus IC Cup and Alliance sitting up there against Kaipi. There's four top teams at the end of the group stages. Well, those teams right there. EG and Quantic, they just want to slip themselves in. Their last slot. It's the only undecided team for the playoffs. EG, they're going to force out the mid-tier one tower. And that means engagement time. Already moving back. Sentry wards, Funzy. Where's this ulti? On cooldown. It was on cooldown by 2 seconds. Hence no dream call. They got Illuminate behind him. Really mops up that creep wave. Demon. Back on the front lines, but Funzy blinks in, throws the ulti, now Jo. I think he was really considering hurling off his ulti just then, concoction, now he will. Funzy, Mana Leak, they got Sentry Wards, and there goes your ulti, but he got used to trigger off the Aegis Immortal, and that was it. So Soshka, now he wants to fight, 4 seconds stun up on Bamboo, with that Phantasm, we got a lot of damage, will it be? A latch up by Mad, no ulti. So he can't get in close, he's still got this Blade Mail, hasn't been used, and there's your pull in by Soshka, Chaos Bolt. Nice four star by Demon. Saves his teammate, but that Urn Charge is still going to tick down a lot of his life points. Not enough to kill him, though. Tier 2 tower now in middle lane will be the next focus. Funzy cleaning up the creep waves so the Radiant one can focus it. Or do they just try and backdoor this? It's going to be close. They don't have enough damage. Even Soshka with his armlet turned on, it's just not enough damage. And that's why the chase is on. Demon. Blink Lasso. Found Funzy. Jo just got to attack him the old-fashioned way. Fear wants to ensure it with a concoction. 20 to 18. Now it's Puck on the sidelines. Aegis the Immortal, of course, was blown by Quantic during that last engagement. Wasn't really worth it for Jo's ultimate. I think he really thought he was going to bounce himself deeper into the lineup of Quantic just then. But it didn't work. He'll bring down that mid tower, 3k gold up on him. If it is just a casual Yasha, there's only 1,000 gold away from having that Aghanim Scepter. Healing Ward to drop, Acid Spray as well. Negative 5 armor on that tower, the Flame Break gonna cancel off that Wild Wings damage, and whoa! 4 staff down by Bamboo. He got Disruption. They try to throw the stun out too. Gomlike, I think he was attempting to deny up that mid-tier 2 tower, but will not be successful. But now EG, they're looking to remove all the remaining out of towers. There's a tier 1 tower up on top lane, which is begging to die. And Juggernaut, yeah it is. If they get this top, they got to give him the last hit here. They got to give him the last hit. And there it is. Oh, he's just short, still 200. Now 150, Aghanim Scepter. They want this thing. This courier should already be traveling to the secret shop. Unless it's waiting for something else. Demon. Who's he want? Anyone. You can't find him. Quantic got too many people in the middle lane. Alchemist getting bigger and bigger too. And there goes your courier. And that's also raiding the observant ward. Watches the purchase of the Aghanim Scepter. Might even be worth the CK ultimate to snipe that little sucker off. The problem is they don't know which direction it'll go. The only direction they could guess was into the dire jungle. And then they have no idea where they'll be facing up once they get there. And it's off. With an Aghanim Scepter up at a level 16 Juggernaut, life just became a lot harder for Quantic. Be it phase shift or not, be it Chen having an undead army or not, it still won't matter. Hand of God and Mech won't save you from that many jumps. Scepter jumps of 12 jumps with the damage he deals. And Rock is trying to keep this middle lane pushed out. Alchemist got to look at a damage dealing item up next. He doesn't really have anything. Alchemist in the previous game, like, he had Magnus to give him the buff up to the Empower. But that was all it's going to be. And EG, they're the ones that are getting this control back now. Not in experience, just in gold. But that was also that huge amount of income they got when they just brought down 3 of the towers. Not to mention, they already should have had, like, the base advantage coming out from Fear. And every time he gets those kills, you look at the bonus money. Roshan, still another 4 minutes away. Beat is bringing Fear in. We've got an ancient stack. A little bit of one. And they'll just babysit Fear through this. Chemical Rage not going to last much longer. In fact, now it wears out. But the Toxic Spray really going to work. And J.O., if he needs to, he'll pop off the Healing Wall, but it's not required. They're just racking up that money into Fear. And this should be him starting on his Abyssal Blade. At the same time now, we get the Aghanim Scepter up on Chen, and we're going to go for a gank. Here we are. Smoke movement. And EG. Where are they going to find this opening? Demon's the first one him to be expected. Firefly up, give him that extra vision. The same time, Quantic, they're moving up north. There's a regeneration rune. And Funzi will bottle that one up after triggering off his DD. Firefly through the middle lane. That's bloody obvious what's happening right there. EG Smoke Gang's going to fail, and Fear reveals himself. And now Quantic, they have the better position advantage here, but Goldblack have been babysat by Funzi where they throw down a very aggressive ward. And EG, they wouldn't have seen that go down. So now it's Quantic with the better intel. We'll see if Bucky Mag can get himself a good latch. Oh, he blew it! Beatus was right on the ward. Rihanna have attempted there on JO2, but he's already used his spin now. And bam, Demon's realizing there's got to be some kind of vision up here. Funzi, silence. Pakulti as well, the orb will fly. No one's really going to take massive amounts of damage from this, but Demon already rifted in, forced up the way, disrupted as well. Goldblack, well, he needs to keep his teammates alive right now. That Hand of God is still available, he pops it off. And then the Illuminate hits on almost all of his teammates. Clockwork goes down for the price of an SD. Fear trying to go on the run, but Soshka right behind him. Those Spirits still do some decent damage, and Fear does go down, but another big Illuminate from Beatiz. But it's just not enough damage. They're just going one to the next. It's a double kill for Soshka. 3 heroes for EG on the sideline. Quantic, however, they're not out of this on home and host. Nice lasso. Silent was trying to take him back to heal him up, and then was going to bring him back so they could keep that pressure on the top tower. But now it's not going to happen. And the Wisp will return. But without the intended healed hero. But EG, that was not the fight they were searching for. That last snipe off was a great thing from Demon. That was the only thing that made that fight balanced in a way. It was still the Alchemist dying for the price of a CK. For a CK not dying. That's the two ones that stay alive. But then again, Alchemist, it doesn't really matter for him because his gold per minute is always going to remain higher. And if he dies, the only thing he gives away is experience. So either way you look at it, there's still three heroes for three heroes. It's not taking money fully away from him. Especially now he's walking around with Battle Fury. So he was looking for that cleave. Mentioned before, didn't have the same thing as Magnus. Bamboo, 4-star TP. Spirit's going to find him, but they can't catch him in time. Now Roshan battle in 30 seconds. Got to look for that quick opening in. And Bucking Mad, he's got to get his initiation perfect. The fact he missed on that Keeper of the Light before, we saw how many of those Illuminates did so much damage from BDs. If they killed off that Keeper of the Light straight from the get-go, and EG still initiated the way they did, we could be looking at Quantic taking Rax right now. But we're not. Because they didn't. But that's big old Captain Hindsight. Now Bucking Mad. His turn again. You can see fear. It's a long way to hook shot, though. The ulti range. You can see it right there. That's as far as she goes. But considering how deep he is, that's kind of fair enough. Who's inside the Radiant Jungle? Demon. Because he took his BT, so he can come in to any fight, anywhere. Doesn't matter. And we'll just keep the pressure on the bottom lane instead. Flame Braid pushing it. There's the TP straight back to base. He is not making any chances here. Gets a BKB up and running. Sentry Ward's on the way down. Roshan's alive now. And Quantic gonna know this. They're trying to leave him enough of a creep wave to damage that tier 2 tower to force someone to come back. And I think the call just said, Demon, get yourself down here. He's already used his BTs. 40 seconds on cooldown for that one. So he couldn't instantly just TP himself in for this. And that tier 2 tower, it shouldn't go down. It'll take a significant amount of damage, but it shouldn't die from this. And the Rock is starting to scout out and see what EG is attempting. Funzy. Is that a Void Stone on the Courier? It is. Scythe of Ice now up. Couldn't have come at a better time for Quantic. Having that Sheep available means that BKB of Demon could be completely nulled, depending on the timing of it all. Bottom lane starting to get a lot of momentum here. Four range creeps. It's enough to do some considerable damage to the tier 3 tower. But not enough to bring it down, same as the tier 2 tower on the top lane. It's not enough to kill it off. Just do the damage. And Quantic gonna group up again. Both teams. It's just full 5-man Dota now. Take no risk. Don't get caught out. CK afforded up a full AC now. That's a very nice thing for him to have. Bounces out the Alchemist AC. And also, better attack speed, better armor for him. Now walking around with 39 armor on that CK. I love Alchemist's damage too. 1-1-1 plus 1-1-1. Makes 2-2-2. Oh! Mathematical genius. Sashka. Batrider, you can already see him wanting it. Blink, BKB. Four-staff him out. Juggernaut just throws out the ulti. If they kill off Sashka here, they're successful. He keeps on bouncing around, but then Hand of God, Soshka's BKB, and 2.6k life points more than enough to help him survive, but not until this! Fear just comes in, the CK goes down, they lose their armor advantage, the Ghost Scepter will not save Bucking Mad right now. Juggernaut will finish him off. Puck's on the retreat, the pings are coming out saying we should go for Roshan, there's no Frost Mage in there. Oh, Wisp! Didn't realize he tried to get himself out with his ultimate. So three heroes dead for Quantic. Now find the Ogre Frost Mage. Demon's already heading back to base. He's got no mana whatsoever. And Fear can handle this, and Beatus will just bring him back anyway. On the end of his ultimate. And that is now Roshan's death. Hark Orb flying. Not anywhere near enough damage to get this kill. And Demon lassoes off cooldown. And that's the reason why he's searching for Funzy. Four staff up. Napalm number one. Secondary Orb. Oh, Funzy! He mustn't have thought. No, there would have been a flame break. There would have been so many things to kill him off. Demon's got Blink in 1 second, and Funzy. Oh, he's on the high ground. Funzy blinked to the high ground. Demon looked to follow him. And because of it, Ponzi was able to get himself down after that. And away to safety. Beautiful play by him, but EG, they just took the... Well, I would say the cheese, but they only took the Aegis. I mean, nibble it on the cheese. 7,500 gold advantage. The experience coming their way as well. With that tower going down. I would normally say this is anybody's game, but really right now, EG, they're the ones. This is their game to lose now. And sorry if you're a massive EG fan, I just completely jinxed you. But this is that period when Game of Thrones does come in. Quantic need the team fight of their life. They attempted it in the middle lane before. And as you saw, CK was very, very buffed up. But the second he dropped, Quantic lost everything. And they're gonna lose Bucky Mad. Cogs. Oh wow, what a savior. Ulti's in. Is he gonna go for the cogs as well? He can't, he ran out of mana. And Funzy, wow, wow! Parked dead instantly, Soshka as well. He'll actually get his Phantasm off and try and bring down Fear, but Geo, he knows the real one. He kills him off, CK on the sidelines. And again, that mana leak, beautifully done by Beaters, is what caused the problem at the very, very start. Bucky Mount will be sent back by Chen. Gold Black will save him, but the bottom racks will not be saved. CK is down, no buyback, short by 1,000 gold. Puck, also no buyback possibly, he's also short by 1,000 gold. And Fear, he's not channeling up Concoction. He wants Rax, this is an objective-based game. He might want fucking Mab. And with that, he throws the stun, throws it towards Gold Black. Could have looked towards Silent too, but either way, bottom Rax to go. EG, now do they commit themselves in deeper? Look for it, and they got the lasso. Mana break as well. Mana leak, sorry. Picking up the clockwork. Saren tried to tether himself in there to save him. Ghost Scepter has to pop with the flame break and bounce him back a little bit further. And EG, they're looking to finish this one now. Tier 3 tower to go down. Mid racks as well. Buyback. Now from the clockwork. Goblin EG, they don't need to stay here any longer. Funzy. Ulti available. Clockwork. Long latch up there from Bucky Mad. Now over to Geo. The spin goes. Demon just going to TP himself out to safety on this one. Nothing could stop that. Wisp ulti on the front lines. J.O. no ulti. He's short by 4 seconds, not to mention his mana. And that's the reason why you see him. He's bottling up. He's still short by 40 mana. He's got no more bottle charges. Aegis the Immortal still on him though, but Wisp, there's just not enough time. And the Radiant's Courier's got sniped off. There's a gem on the deck. Soshka will pick it up. I was also carrying Lifesteal exactly in the position of the gem. So Jam, I assume, was on the courier when it dropped. But even more success coming for EG. Bamboo. Silence Funzy too far away. Clockwork. Latches, but he only hit onto Funzy. And now Bamboo caught in a corner. He ran down when he had to run up. But at the same time, the rest of EG want to fight this one up again. That mana leak. Up on the clockwork. Goblin. Juggernaut bouncing around. It's a fine for him if that blade mail is up and running. Goes into a spin. It's huge damage across all three, especially when Beat is. Again, he's been 100% in the money. When it comes to these beautiful Illuminas, able to force up himself away from Funzy. The Soshka stunned up. Wisp. He comes in. He pulls him out. He'll have to come back to die. There is no other solution here. Funzy has ulti in 1 second, throws the orb in. The Firefly is going down. He's trying to give him a tether option, and Silent actually brought back the CK flame break, bouncing him back. Demon into his BKB as well as Firefly. They're still fighting on top of the fire and the flames, and Soshka, he's gonna burn this one just like we saw the Wisp. And now back to Gold Black. He will go down as well. Bamboo picks up a double kill. 25 to 32, it might even be a team wipe. They've got to pick up the puck, but which direction will he go? And he goes east, and orbs further. Demon, Funzy, he caught, oh yeah, he's down. Just down the cliff. The mid racks, however, will be the next casualty of war. EG is making a beeline in through the bottom. And it looks like Keeper of the Lies dragging in the last one. Batrider. All five heroes now for EG, and they may finish up this mid racks. And just push for the GG. There's a lot of momentum there. Puck jumps in. Funzy got a good silence off. But Demon right behind him. Blink looking for the lasso. The cogs from Bucky Mal push him back. And this really is GG. They will pull the clockwork back out again. Maybe JO will finish him off, which he does do so. But EG will eliminate Quantic in the tiebreaker. And give the last team, which means we'll have ourselves an All-American with a little bit of bamboo. Round one, matchup in the playoffs. Dignitas will face up against EG. Quantic, with that game, are eliminated from the defense. Well, it's just a best of one tiebreaker. We can only have one victor, and that's where it's going to end. If you want to stay tuned, peoples, and you missed the game from earlier tonight, Now Sports versus Next.KZ, then definitely stay tuned. The best of three matchup. That was the first playoff game. It'll be coming up in just a couple of moments' time with the rebroadcast. But thanks for watching, guys. Remember, no live stream tomorrow, but we will be back on Monday, and that'll be coming up with VP playing their game, the All-Russian matchup. If I check the details over on my side to make sure I get them right, it is, in fact, VP going up against Team Empire. That's right, Light of Heaven and crew will be playing up at 18 CEST then. So stay tuned for that one, or stay tuned for the rebroadcast. Thanks for watching, however you look at it, and have yourself a fantastic weekend.
I said good day, sir!